accuracy in cosplay, finding fabric that matches the colors of your character's outfit may be one of the biggest challenges you face. But fear not, we have the technology to change that. Fabric dyeing is a great solution to the conundrum of finding that perfect fabric. That being said, it can be a bit tricky, if only because it does involve a little bit of chemistry. Don't worry, you won't need to whip out your Bunsen burners or anything, but you will need to have a basic knowledge of fabric types and what dyes will work with certain fibers. In this video, I'm going to cover the process of figuring out how to dye your fabric, since that can be a lot trickier than the actual dye job. I'll go over the most commonly used methods for dyeing fabric in cosplay, along with some recommendations for specific brands of dye. Let me preface this, I'm not being paid or sponsored for any of these product recommendations in this video. These are just the products that I've liked most and had the best experiences with over my many years of costume making. To begin, let's cover the three main types of fabric dye you're going to encounter as a cosplayer. These are the kinds that are the easiest to use and also the most budget-friendly, as well as being the least hazardous methods of dyeing fabric. Most often you're going to be using all-purpose dyes. These are the dyes you'll see at your local craft stores, supermarkets like Walmart, etc. As the name implies, it works on different types of fabric because it includes a mix of different dye types. All-purpose dyes require the use of hot water, and for some fibers you may need to add a little bit of extra stuff like salt, vinegar, or detergent. These dyes have the benefit of only really needing one step, but because they're designed for use on a ton of different fibers, their effectiveness is pretty limited. Your color results may turn out rather dull, or they might lack intensity, and your dye job may fade if you happen to put your costume through the laundry. That being said, all-purpose dyes work great in a pinch. My favorite brands are RIT Liquid Dye and Dylan. Liquid RIT dye is nice because it doesn't have any granules in it that may stain or spot your fabric, and both brands have a great selection of colors. Next up is fiber reactive dye. This is the most permanent type of fabric dye, and it's also still very easy for beginners to use. They're used primarily for all natural fibers like wool, cotton, silk, and rayon. Best part, fiber reactive dyes will help you achieve colors that won't fade with washing. In order for these dyes to work, you will need additional chemicals like soda ash fixative, and you'll want to practice proper safety protocol by wearing a dust mask and gloves. Dharma Trading Company has a huge selection of fiber reactive dyes, so I highly recommend checking them out. If you're shopping in-store, Dylan also makes a line of fiber reactive dyes, and Jacquard offers Eye Dye Poly. As the name implies, Eye Dye Poly can be used on synthetic fibers as well. Lastly, my favorite, acid dyes. If you followed along with my cosplay adventures, you'll have seen me use acid dye on various projects like Yona, Chic, and most recently, Rapidash. Acid dye is a powder dye formulated for dyeing protein fibers like wool, silk, cashmere, and even materials like leather and feathers. The colors turn out super vibrant, and like fiber reactive dyes, they won't fade when washing. Don't let the name acid intimidate you. These dyes are very safe to use. There's a bit of a learning curve in terms of mixing colors and getting your ratios correct, but it's really not that challenging. I prefer using Dharma Trading's brand of acid dyes, especially when working with silk fabrics, and Jacquard has a fantastic line of acid dye too. While not mentioned in this video, there are still many, many, many different methods of dyeing fabric, such as tea staining, rust staining, food coloring, and even using some vegetables and fruits to create natural dyes. So if these chemical dyes aren't giving you the results you need, feel free to think outside the box. As you can see, there is a wide variety of fabric dyes out there, but only certain dyes work with certain fabrics. So first and foremost, we need to figure out what type of fiber we're trying to dye. You can do this by looking at the product information on the website you purchased it from, or the sticker that's on the fabric bolt at the store. And obviously, if you're dyeing an existing garment, you can just look at the care tag. There are three types of fibers you're most commonly going to encounter: cellulose fibers, protein fibers, and synthetic fibers. Cellulose fibers are derived from plants, and they include fabrics like cotton, rayon, hemp, and bamboo. To dye these fibers, you'll want to use all-purpose dyes or fiber-reactive Procyon dyes. Protein fibers are derived from animals, and they include fabrics like wool, silk, and cashmere. Acid dyes and fiber-reactive dyes will give you the best results here. You can still use all-purpose dyes, but you may end up with really low-intensity color or fading. Synthetic fibers, on the other hand, are the most difficult to dye. So to ensure that the fabric takes to your dye, you'll want to stick with Eye Dye Poly, which was specifically developed for use with man-made fibers. Keep in mind, these are just general guidelines. If you're confused about a specific fiber or fabric content, pop on over to Google and see what is specifically recommended for your material. After determining what type of dye is best for your fabric, acquire your dye and any additional materials. These supplies will change depending on the type of dye you're using and what method you're using. Minimally, you'll need rubber gloves, a face mask, a bucket or pot for your dye bath, something to stir with, a measuring cup, and hot water. Depending on what dye you're using, you may also need supplies like vinegar, detergent, soda ash, or salt. But let's be real, we have plenty of that to go around. Before dyeing, be sure to pre-wash your fabric to remove any surface finishes or chemicals that could interfere with the dye process. And then just follow the steps for your chosen method of dyeing. Again, this video is just a basic introductory guide, so for this step, please consult the instructions that came with your dye. Your exact dyeing process will change depending on whether you're using all-purpose dyes, acid dyes, or fiber-reactive dyes. The general process is to mix up your dye, dissolve it in your hot water bath, add your dampened fabric, and constantly agitate it while it sits in the bath. Again, check your instructions to see how long it needs for the color to set. After that time has elapsed, rinse your fabric with cold water to remove the excess dye, and then let it dry. And voila, you now have accurately colored fabric. Dyeing fabric is one of the most versatile skills you can have as a cosplayer. It can be used for so many fantastic effects, so don't be afraid to get creative and experiment with different processes. Thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to support the Cosplay 101 series, feel free to check out my Patreon. And don't forget to subscribe for more cosplay videos. I'm Mango Cyrene, and as always, happy cosplay!